You're awake. How about that? Whoa, easy there, easy. You've been out cold a couple of days now. Why don't you just relax a second? Get your bearings. Let's see what the damage is. How about your name? Can you tell me your name? I can't say it's what I'd have picked for you, but if that's your name, that's your name. I'm Doc Mitchell. Welcome to Good Springs. Now, I hope you don't mind, but I had to go rooting around there in your noggin to pull all the bits of lead out. I take pride in my needlework, but you'd better tell me if I left anything out of place. How'd I do? Well, I got most of it right anyway. Stuff that mattered. Okay. No sense keeping you in bed anymore. Let's see if we can get you on your feet. Good. Ooh, looking good. That explains. What do you say you? All right. Before I turn you, I got a form for you to fill out, so just a form. All right, I guess that about does it. Here. Thank you.
bet it feels real.
How lucky can one guy be? I kissed her. Like a fella once said, ain't that a kick in the head? The room was completely black. I have been, she hugged.
Beg your pardon, but.
How may I be of service?
Hey, babe. Hello, babe. What in the god? Benny's gonna show you. You're platinum pussy. The eyes.
I love these robots with. They're friendly little policeman faces. Sure, they still rough.
You know you want a piece of this. Give me some shit.
Hey, no one...
Well, howdy, partner.
Where to, partner?
Penthouse floor.
Enjoy your time. Obituaries of the recently deceased Mr. House. President,
CEO. Hey, you there. I have a message.
Come to Mick and Ralph's for all your shopping needs.
Thank you.
Hold it right there.
I'll take this from here.
Welcome, Chot.
Hey.
Thank you for visiting New Vegas.
What? Are you serious?
I gotta see that.
Wow.
It's hard to sleep in this place, I tell you. Last night.
Like a fella once said, ain't that a kick in the head?
Oh! Ha!
The room was completely black.
Step closer to the demonstration area, please. Okay, so you're familiar with Securitrons by now, obviously. I mean, some of your best friends are Securitrons, right? Our titanium alloy housing does a good job for protecting our delicate electronic insides from small arms, fire, and shrapnel. Our left arm contains an X-25 Gatling laser, quite deadly against soft targets in medium reach. That looks like fun. And for close-range suppression and crowd control, we have this handy-dandy 9mm submachine gun. Nice. All of this is old hat, right? Here is where it gets interesting. Turns out that those are our secondary weapons. All this time, we've been running the Mark I operating system, which doesn't have drivers for our primary weapons. Imagine! Now watch this. I'm downloading the Mark II OS to all Securitrons on the network. Makes quite a difference. With the M235 missile launcher, we can engage ground and aircraft at close range. And a rapid fire E-28 launching system makes us deadly in close range engagements. Woo! Look at that! The OS upgrade also includes drivers for our onboard auto repair systems. Just try to hurt us now! Altogether, this software upgrade confers a 235% increase in combat effectiveness per unit. New Vegas finally has soldiers worthy of protecting it. I hope you enjoyed this demonstration. You can come back up and see me or be on your way. I know you're a busy person.
You did a soup! Here's some big news. Every secure...
You look new to free.
Thank you for visiting New Vegas.
Don't you love seeing...
You must get to the control room and install the override chip.
Fake it.
Caesar on the cross. Guess it ain't no secret.
did a soup.
And so the courier who had cheated death in the cemetery outside Good Springs cheated death once again, and the Mojave Wasteland was forever changed. The courier, with the aid of Yes Man, drove both the Legion and the NCR from Hoover Dam, securing New Vegas' independence from both factions. With Mr. House out of the picture, the remaining Securitrons on the Strip were hard-pressed to keep order. Anarchy ruled the streets. When the fires died, New Vegas remained, assuming its position as an independent power in the Mojave. Preferring neither the best of the NCR nor the worst of the Legion, the courier was the woman responsible for a truly independent New Vegas. She had removed Mr. House from power over the Strip and broken the influence of the NCR and Caesar's Legion in the Mojave Wasteland.
Black Mountain Radio continued to broadcast its peculiar form of propaganda. Raul Tejada faced his execution each day, though pardoned in the end. Travelers venturing too near Black Mountain continued to be harassed by Tabitha's followers.
With little law left in the wasteland, the Booms continued to defend themselves against the prospectors and scavengers invading their territory.
The Brotherhood used the Battle of Hoover Dam as an opportunity to retake Helios One, and came to control the area between it and Hidden Valley. With no organized opposition, their patrols began monitoring trade along I-15 and 95, seizing any items of technology they deemed inappropriate.
Fiends overran Camp McCarran during the Second Battle of Hoover Dam. In the anarchic months that followed, the Fiends asserted dominance over Outer Vegas.
After the courier ensured New Vegas remained free, the followers found that independent Vegas was even more unstable and violent than before. Old Mormon Fort became excessively burdened by the influx of patients, struggling to provide even the most basic of services.
With New Vegas's independence formally declared, Good Springs thrived. More travelers stopped by Good Springs on their way to and from the Strip, and the locals grew prosperous from the traffic.
The Kings retained their control of Freeside, and while they continued to favor the needs of locals, they tolerated the citizens of the defeated NCR.
Armed with a wide array of improvised explosives and stolen weapons, the Vault 19 Powder Gang tormented the Mojave Wasteland for years. Citizens of the NCR were favorite targets, and they always suffered the worst fates.
And so the courier's road came to an end, for now. In the new world of the Mojave Wasteland, fighting continued, blood was spilled, and many lived and died just as they had in the old world. Because war never changes.